If you quit smoking, eventually you probably could buy a house with the money you save. Murray Kelly crossing the bridge from smoker to non-smoker.
The journey of self-discovery that began for me, I found very tough. I had a painful confrontation with the selfish self, the addicted core, the thing I called the friend. And I had to say goodbye to that friend, and I didn't want to. Even when I made up my mind, I didn't want to say goodbye. And I really missed him, and I struggled. He wanted to get back. The only way he could get back was to get me to have a cigarette. Some people seem to just let go, and they begin anew. They don't seem to be troubled by it. While others, like me, seem to have to struggle to transform ourselves in a whole new way. And not just the smoking thing, but everything else. Our own self-image has to change. The social person has to change. The coper. You just got to want to quit. Struggle or not, easy or hard, you just got to want to quit. Being with my son now as a non-smoker is really very rewarding. My wife has since quit as well, smoking, and we're a family of non-smokers at the moment, which is really incredible. Nobody smoking around us. That takes a lot of the pressure off. And I know that every day, I go 4, 5, 6 days now, never even really think about having a cigarette. I think I had my mind made up that I'd never quit, that I'd never have to quit. And my little boy was born, and my whole life changed, and I knew I didn't want to pass that on to him. And it's love of life, and I think love of life will always beat fear of death. It's done so far.
Health and Welfare made this comment back in the 60s.
Aside from smoking, what else are cigarettes good for? They're excellent for burning holes in suits, fine for starting fires, good for scorching antiques, great for making spies talk, and of course, unexcelled in their benefits to the medical profession, especially lung and heart specialists.
Smoking cessation expert, Kendra Smith.
Watch the trickiness of the psychological addiction. It can hit you when you least expect it and when you're most vulnerable. When you hit a personal crisis, what you've always done before is reach for the cigarette. Be careful. Watch your thoughts. Stay on track.